what it is a redoubt. You feel me? Nah.
Nah.
Nigga, but why I keep fucking up? Fuck, bitch.
Like in every nigga picture, that's a red flag. Phone on do not disturb, that's a red flag. Calling every nigga brother, that's a red flag. You don't ask me for no rubber, that's a red flag. You don't cook, you don't clean, that's a red flag. No designer in your closet, that's a red flag. Ain't no money in your wallet, that's a red flag. Popping pussy on the car, that's a red flag. Selling pussy on your period, that's a red rag. You ain't never got your kids, that's a red flag. Knowing every nigga dead, that's a red flag. You ain't trying to get no bread, that's a red flag. Pulling up with bad tags, that's a red flag. Stealing out of Walgreens, that's a red flag. You got five baby daddies, that's a red flag. You still staying with your mama, that's a red flag. Speaking down on your nigga, that's a red flag. Your frontal always lifting up, that's a red flag. Your lashes always coming off, that's a red flag. The bitch always running off, that's a red flag. You tuck your tag in your shirt, that's a red flag. Bitch, you be stealing where you work, that's a red flag. You keep popping all these perks, that's a red flag. You say you scamming, it don't work, that's a red flag.
Man, what's good? Y'all tapping into Urban Moguls with B. Right here, we dropped the most game, man. Today, we got a real special guest. He goes by the name of Just Bang. Look, man, before we start this interview, go hit that subscribe button, that like button, that notification bell. And when you got some time, go check out some other interviews while you're at it. You feel me? But look, man, we right here with Just Bang, bro. Go ahead, let the people know where you from, what you do, and what's your ethnicity.
My name's Jess Bang. I'm from the Dubs, Murder Dubs, a part of Oakland, one of probably the biggest historical spots in the town right now. My ethnicity, man, I'm from Zimbabwe. No, I'm just playing. I'm just dark skinned, you know.
Yeah.
Black nigga, you know what I'm saying? But that's pretty much, you feel me?
Right on. What's so historic about the Dubs? I mean, I don't even know.
It's our history. It's historical to us. You feel me? Okay. Like, a lot of motherfuckers probably know about it. A lot of motherfuckers probably don't. But, like, it mean that much to me that it's historical. It's like, once I go, a motherfucker gonna know where I'm from. You feel me? Same way with some of the biggest people that I come up under, or even some of my young niggas. Like, you feel me? R.P. Vendell, R.P. Buck, Willie Clay, my young nigga Lil Eli just passed. Like, when they go, they gonna know them with some dub niggas. You feel me?
Well, yeah, man. Let's jump right into it right now. What was it like growing up in Oakland or your section at a young age?
Shit, I ain't gonna lie. I didn't see too much growing up. I didn't see shit that I could talk about, shit that I can't talk about. When, shit, I moved to the Dubs when I was in the third grade. I stayed in the village. And I stayed in 65ville before I moved to the Dubs.
Okay.
But shit, before I moved to 65, I stayed on 25th. I stayed in the Dubs on 25th. And then I moved to the Ville. I did I stayed a couple years in the Ville till like around the third grade. Then I moved to the Dubs. And I've been in the Dubs ever since, but shit, I didn't see too much.
Well, what was that experience like? I'm not sure if, you know, it's a problem going from a section to another section. If, you know, kids look at you different or try to press your line because you ain't born and raised there.
I mean, that shit just like being grown. Like, you feel me? Like, if you was an older nigga coming from a certain part of the city and then you come trying to adapt to another part, a lot of motherfuckers ain't gonna gravitate to you just so easily. You feel me? And that was the same for me. When I moved to the Dubs, it was kids that was there in kindergarten to the third. You feel me? So.
Yeah.
It was, who was this nigga when you came to school? But shit, by the first day of school, it was over with, nigga. It was over with.
Yeah.
Feel me? After the first day, everybody knew who I was. Yeah. I stayed on my block. It wasn't like I stayed two blocks down or three blocks up and then was like, oh, this where I'm from. Like, I stayed on my shit, you feel me? But, you know, it's Oakland, so nigga, rather when I stayed in the Ville, when I stayed in the Dubs, I didn't see too much. when I stayed in the Ville, they used to call, it was, when I stayed in the Ville, I stayed right across the street from Havens Court. That was the high school, you feel me, right? That was a high school in East Oakland, Havens Court. Lockwood was the elementary school, Havens Court was the high school. They used to have a baseball field right across the street from my shit. They used to call it Dead Man Park. Cause them niggas used to be funking so hard, they used to just leave bodies and shit over there. They called it Dead Man Park. And the Dubs, it's just the Murder Dubs. That shit crazy. I just seen
self-explanatory.
Man, I seen my best friend get killed at like 13 years old. I seen five people shot, two die. I seen that shit. Lil Willie Clay and Jay Black, they passed away. Man. I seen that shit my own eyes. That was the first time I seen somebody. Mind you, I'm from Oakland, I didn't went to sleep to gunshots. Woke up to sirens. You feel me? So it was like it was normal. You feel me? But to actually see that shit firsthand, like not just hear it, like actually see that shit, like that shit fucked me up.
What kind of PTSD at a young age? How does that really affect you? Does it make you actually like have some animosity grow within inside of you? Or is it like, man, I gotta stay out the way because, you know, it happens to people randomly sometimes, you know?
That shit different. Like, you feel me? Like, that PTSD shit, it go a long way. You feel me? It might stop for a minute. It might go away for a little bit, but that shit always come back. Like, you feel me? Like, it's like riding a bike with PTSD. Like, you're gonna forget about it, but you're gonna always know about that shit. You're gonna always know how to do it. I got PTSD shit, I got anxiety, all that shit, but that shit come from my history of being in the streets. I done been shot a couple of times. I got PTSD from that shit. But that shit help you stay alive though.
Right.
You feel me? Like a motherfucker might be like, oh, you scary, you paranoid. A motherfucker that ain't paranoid or ain't scary is a motherfucker that's slipping. A nigga that think it's just cool and ain't nothing gonna happen to him, and then something happen to him because you think you bigger than who you is, you feel me? Like, the biggest motherfuckers get grabbed.
Yeah.
That nigga PNB Rock got smoked from dropping the location.
Man,
you feel me? So it's just like, it can happen to the best of us.
And I mean, shit, with that being said, bro, you know, there's a lot of artists, you know, getting caught slipping and, you know, passing away and whatnot. What do you think they need to know ahead of time, you know, coming to the Bay Area? Because a lot of it's going on in LA, down south, right? But the Bay Area is dangerous as well, you know what I'm saying?
You know, this is one of the dangerous cities fucking with the Bay. So if you ask me, if you're going to come to this motherfucker, just be careful. You feel me? Like, stick to yourself, have security, you know what I'm saying? And just make sure you straight, you feel me? Like, I'd be cool. Like, 9 times out of 10, if I go out, I ain't going out unless I got security with me.
Right.
Or if I got a group of motherfuckers with me.
Yeah.
I be having my uncle with me, bald head, that he make sure I'm straight everywhere I go. Yeah. Debo, I might have Debo with me. You feel me?
Roscoe. Pulling up on the bike and shit on Debo.
Yeah. That's my man. It's a Mac guy. Like, you feel me?
Yeah, yeah.
They make sure I'm straight everywhere I go. Like, I be having my young niggas. I be having some of my older niggas tell me, like, man, stay on your shit. Be careful. Woo, woo.
Right.
But I know who to call when I come to this motherfucker.
Hell yeah. How do you bounce back? Because you mentioned that you've been shot before. And, you know, wondering, how do you bounce back from that? How do you able to just keep moving on with life, man? Because I feel like if that were to happen, it's like something where it's like, man, you super paranoid. You know what I mean?
And I was paranoid before I got shot. You feel me? So it's like being shot. Yeah, shit, it's a part of the lifestyle. You feel me? You don't get too many second chances though, so you just gotta pick God first. As long as he wake you up in the morning and he got something bigger in store for you. It ain't just what you shopping for. You feel me? So I took that shit. I took it the way it was. It was karma. It came back to me. You feel me? Due to who I was in the streets. You feel me? So he gave me a second chance. I'm just gonna take it and run with it.
You feel me?
I ain't gonna let. I got a career, I got kids, you feel me? So I ain't gonna let the streets determine who I am as a man or determine how long I'm gonna be on this motherfucker, you feel me?
You got purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Man, let's bend the block real quick. How many siblings did you have, man, growing up? What was the household like? You had both parents, one parent?
I had one parent growing up. I know my daddy, or, you feel me? Like, I ain't gonna say I know of him because I know the nigga, you feel me? But as far as me, I'm 30 years old. So within a 30 year span, I seen that nigga enough times I can count on my hands.
Yeah.
And that's amount. That's probably the same amount of time he didn't see my kids, you feel me? Yeah. I got two daughters.
My bad, I'm gonna cut you off. That's why, I mean, one of your verses in your songs, I think you said, they gonna say I'm Perry's son. I'm gonna say I'm Tammy's baby, right?
Yeah, they gonna say I'm Perry's son. I'm gonna say I'm Tammy's baby. A lot of motherfuckers gonna be like, you look like your daddy.
Mm.
And I'm be like, yeah, but I'm my mama's child. My mama had to play the mom and the daddy. Feel me? She had to play nigga. She had to play Santa and all that shit. Like, you feel me? She got three kids, one job. You feel me? Sometimes my sister had to start school before me and my brother because she had to get her clothes before she got ours. You feel me? We had to sacrifice some of that shit. I got to a certain age where I didn't even have Christmas no more.
Yeah.
You feel me? So like my household, at one point, I got three siblings that I could say two. I could say my sister and my older brother, Joseph and Dominique. That's my sister. That's my little brother. That's my little sister and my older brother name. But I got four cousins, first cousins, Pooh, DeMarie, Deja, and Danye. Them my cousins, them my first cousins, that's my mama, little sister,
right.
Kids, you feel me? At one time, nigga, when I stayed on the eight, where I'm from, we all stayed in that motherfucker.
Man.
I'm talking about not just a couple months, I'm talking about a couple years. Like, we done did school years with each
same
other. I'm talking about same bed. Yeah. Nigga, just imagine staying in one household with it's a three bedroom. We got at least 13 motherfuckers in one house.
Yeah.
It's my granny. My granny just passed on my baby mama birthday, like last year. So it was my granny, my mama, my auntie, my brother, my sister, and my four cousins. That's nine people. And my uncle was staying there and his two kids. And then shit, I remember one time my auntie, her house burned down with her apartment building. Her shit like caught on fire. They had to come up there. So then we was like 15 deep in a three bedroom. It's like
hot as fuck up now.
Hot as fuck. Everybody fans not working. Like, man, it was living like that will make you appreciate what you got now. Like, you feel me? Not only it'll make you appreciate what you got now, it'll make you love your family more.
Mm-hmm.
Because niggas didn't have to go through shit. We didn't have to sleep on the same bed, sleep on the floor. I didn't have to sacrifice my own bed for some people to sleep in my bed.
Right.
It was times to where I say around the seventh grade. Mind you, I've been in the streets since I moved to the Duds. Third grade, I was outside.
Yeah.
So by the time the seventh grade, I ain't even coming home. Seventh grade, eighth grade, from the sixth to the eighth grade, I'm staying outside. I'm sleeping at my partner Twaddle house on 22nd and Foothill.
Yeah.
Nigga, it's me. I'm talking about, we still 20 deep in that motherfucker. Yeah. It's me, Twaddle, nigga, Offset Gym, all black. Nigga,
oh, damn.
I'm talking about, we in that motherfucker 20, 30 deep. Nigga, we 15 deep in one room. And some nigga sleeping in his sister room, some sleeping in his other sister room, like, nigga, so it'll make you appreciate that shit. You feel
Hell
me?
Yeah.
So it's like, going back to me looking at pictures and shit and seeing how we lived at first, and even for me staying in Vegas and coming back to Oakland and seeing how my mom and them live to this day, not saying that they poor or they struggling,
right, right.
But they still my family and not just stay in a different city. You feel me?
Yeah.
But like coming back home, it just make me appreciate them more, and it make me feel like it made me grind harder to, I gotta move them too now. You feel me?
Keeps you prideful and you know.
I start tripping, like
ambitious.
I have anxiety attacks and all that type of shit. I come home. I'm doing too much on the road. That shit fucking with my head, nigga. I come home. I leave my own house in Vegas and come stay with my mom and them for a couple of days.
Yeah.
Just so I can get back to reality type shit. You know
right.
what I mean?
Man, so. You know, growing up with a packed house, you being in the streets, you ever get involved with, how far did you go into, like, school? Like, did you graduate? You play any sports in school or what?
Hell no, I ain't graduated. Right. I dropped out of school in the 10th grade.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't never go back for no GED, no nothing. I tried one time when I had got out of jail, I had tried to go to Laney College. and try to go for my GED and all that type of shit. I was in that motherfucker for like 2 days. I think I didn't even make it through. I think I made it to getting my classes type shit.
Yeah.
But it was just too much for me. I'm like, man, I'm not gonna, it wasn't, school wasn't my, I didn't, it didn't keep my attention type shit. Like when I was going to school for the bitches. Like I wasn't going to school for nothing else. Like I ain't gonna lie, I already knew how to read and count. Like that's all, at the end of the day, that's all. 9 times out of 10, you can get a diploma right now, you still ain't gonna get the job you want.
Right, right.
You feel me? So it was like, I learned from me growing up and seeing my OGs, like the good and the bad, I already learned what I want to do in life. You feel me? I seen certain motherfuckers play basketball. Yeah. The only nigga in my age group that I ever went to school with that made it in basketball was Damon Lillard. We went to the same school with each other. Like,
oh, y'all same age?
Yeah. So if I'm 30, he about 30 or 31, something like that. You feel me? But like other than that, like, that was the only person I knew from my age group, my class, that was able to make it.
So
Jabari Brown too. Jabari Brown, he went to the Lakers.
Right.
And Jameel Brown, he could have went to the league too. He one of the hottest DJs out right now though.
For sure.
DJ Mill, DJ Butter, Drew Banger, Slim, like them the hardest DJs out right now.
Yeah, I was gonna say since you dropped out of school, who was someone that you looked up to that was like, you know, that kept you level-headed in the streets, or someone that gave you game all the time and, you know, just kind of show you the ropes? I'm not saying you need the ropes.
The older niggas from my hood. Like, the older niggas from my hood, it was some good, some was bad. Some niggas always kept a job, rather they was in the streets or not. Some of them kept going back and forth to jail, you feel me? Some of them prospered and had shit going for themselves. Niggas, some of them ain't never did shit.
Yeah.
You feel me? So it was, I had an older nigga named Tick from the hood. Growing up, like, everybody knew Tick from drinking. You feel me? He was drunk one time. It was 2000, this was around 2006, 2007. It was hella shit going on in the hood. I'm going back to the house. He damn near the only person that was outside. There was a couple niggas outside, but they was leaving. He asked me, like, where you gonna see yourself 10 years from now? Nigga, I'm hella young. I'm like 13 at the time. Nigga, I don't know where I'm gonna be 10 years from now. So I told the nigga, like, I don't know. He told me, nigga, if you don't know where you go, he like, go home then. I'm like, I'm on my way to the house. He like, you ain't going home because I'm kicking you off the spot. He like, nigga, you going home because you need to think about where you gonna be 10 years from now. Because if you don't know where you gonna be 10 years from now, nigga, you gonna be right here with me.
Man.
And to this day, he ain't even 10 years from him telling me that story. That nigga don't even drink no more. He got a clothing line. He got a job. He doing all.
Leading by example.
Like, leading by example. Like that's somebody that I can be like. He taught me. He told me something that he followed his own. Like, you know how motherfuckers be like, preach what.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like,
practice
what you preach. He's somebody that actually practiced what he preached. It. You feel me? Like, no matter how far along it was. Like, you feel me? I don't know how long it took for him to stop drinking as much. I ain't gonna say that he just a saint and he don't get a beer after work or nothing like that, but like,
he did that though.
He did that though. Like, he ain't no, I ain't gonna say he was a drunk, but he was drinking. You feel
hell
me?
Yeah.
I done lost my uncle to it. I know what a drunk is. I done lost my uncle to drinking. You feel me?
So hell yeah. Well, man, look, I don't mean to cut you off. Last question before we jump into part two. What's some game you could give back to the youth, the people watching this, who might be in poverty, the hood, ghetto, you know what I'm saying?
Relax, that's it. Relax and go to school. Don't be rushing to try to be what we done been through, like, or do the shit that they done seen us do and try to, like, you know, like,
don't repeat the cycle.
Don't repeat the cycle. You know, you can follow somebody's footsteps, you feel me, but you gotta leave your own footprints behind for a motherfucker that respects you, understand who you is as a man. Cause I done bump my head, like, I was doing all of the above before I really focused on rapping. Yeah. Like, I've been rapping all my life, but before I focus on like this, what I want to do, nigga, I'm doing everything. I'm getting money out of bitches. I'm bipping. I'm, nigga, whatever it could. Like, I was bipping for years. Like, you feel me? Like, not trying to stop. You feel me? Because I was making money off that shit. But like, it's young niggas. I got young niggas to this day that'll be like, bro, I need to bounce in with Woonty Woomp. I need to go fuck with this nigga. Like, you think they gonna let me bounce in? I tell them, nigga, yeah, they gonna let you bounce in, but is that what you wanna go through? You want to go through a high speed. You want the police, nigga, pin trackers on your car. You want your mama house getting kicked in.
Shit that comes with it that they don't know.
They don't know what come with that shit. Like, it's shit that come with that shit that you gonna regret at the end of the day. A nigga, if I would have kept doing that shit, I wouldn't be sitting here with you right now. We'd be doing this interview off the phone. Press 9.
What's up?
Global Telling.
Man. All
right, come on.
Well, shit, man. With that being said, we're going to jump into part 2. If you're watching it, subscribe to the channel. Hit that notification bell, that like button. Y'all tapping into Urban Moguls with B. Right here, we drop the most game. Let's go.